ponds, rivers, and wells brim and overflow for the welfare of all. வாழ்கவையகம் வாழ்கவையகம் வாழ்கவளமுடன். May peace prevail within us. May peace prevail around us. May peace prevail all over the world. Peace, peace, peace. Rub the palms together, place them over the eyes, and then wipe the face gently with the palms. Raise both arms over the head. Take a deep breath and release it. Bring hands down along the sides and open your eyes gently. Vaazhga Valamudan, thank you for the wonderful opportunity. Vaazhga Valamudan.
Be blessed by the divine. Thank you, ma'am, for conducting Shanti meditation. And thank you so much for managing the English evening meditation for this entire week. Dear Sky Meditators, I am very happy to welcome all of you to this spiritual session in English organized by the World Community Service Center IT team. The soul is a mystic force. It is a subtle and ethereal phenomenon. Illusionary ideas about the soul have been fostered through the centuries, and religious propagandists have been circulating many stories about the soul as though it could be perceived through the senses. All the current theories about the state of the soul before birth and after death are the outcome of mere imagination. It is the yogi who has the means to get at the truth. The yogi realizes the existence of the soul by his subtle state of mental activity. With this understanding, the yogi is able to trace the link of the soul before birth and after death. One such great yogi is our guru. His vision is nature's revelation. To explain this interesting concept of life before birth and after death in detail, we have our beloved professor, Sri Satyamurthy sir, with us today. Sir worked in Department of Space for a period of 5 years under Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Then he worked in L&T Limited for 5 years and as Managing Director of Fab Machines Private Limited, Bangalore for 30 years. Sir completed his Sky Master course in 1989 and rendering his divine service for the past 32 years. Sir is the Managing Trustee of Bangalore Malleshwaram Sky Trust. He is presently developing a residential training institute called Vetri, that is Vedatri Educational Training and Research Institute at Hosur Tali Road, and it is affiliated to the World Community Service Center. I now invite our beloved senior professor, C. Satyamurthy sir, to deliver his speech on the topic Life Before Birth and Life After Death. Be blessed by the divine.
Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Salutations to Guru Vedatri Maharshi. My pranams to our beloved president, the trustees of World Community Service Center, and those who are tirelessly working in the IT team and spreading the message of Swamiji throughout the world through Zoom. And those who are joined today in the Zoom. Once again, my pranams to your parents, those who are instrumental, or those who are unfulfilled desire propelled you here to be in Vedatriyam, to learn this unbelievable technique devised by Vedatri Maharshi. So today I'm going to share my knowledge and experience gained over a period of time, the life before birth and life after death. I'll be just a minute, slide is not moving. Okay. before going to the life before birth, because we are all born and we are living today. So let us not bother. Let us see the life before birth a little after. And today we are living. So let us see the life, what it is, and what is human life. Human life is a gift and a way to improve or evolve our self to the higher level of spirituality. Among all species, human being are the only one who have a very developed brain. That is for a purpose, to think and do things in a logical way. So just say yourself that we are a powerful soul. We are a pure soul and a happy soul. A soul full of love and compassion, always wanting peace with in and around. A knowledgeable soul wanting to be in the state of bliss all the time. See, that is what is human life. But is it there? Able to manage or able to live peacefully and happily 24/7 into 365 days? Difficult to say. So what is the meaning of life? What is the definition of life? Life is the aspect of existence that processes, acts, reacts, evaluates through growth, reproduction, and metabolism. The crucial difference between the life and the non-life, the non-living things, that life uses the energy for physical and conscious development. So life is a journey of consciousness. It is not a destination. Life is not what we get. Life is what we make and live happily and peacefully. Of course, it is hard yet beautiful. It is worth to learn and live by guided by a guru. So for that, our life should be a divine life. Why? You may ask why it should be a divine life. To shed the animal imprints, the animal qualities, or the kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya, and to sublimate the human in him into a divine. To express the sublimation in our daily, hourly, a day-to-day life, in thought, word, and deed. That is what is true life. It is every attempt to cultivate divine virtues, selfless service, straightforwardness, truth, courage, serenity, generosity, adaptability, acceptability, mercy, and self-restraint. This is the reality in divine life. So, ever to keep an equilibrium in mind, in success or failure, or pain and pleasure, honor or dishonor, gain or loss, heat or cold. Another important in our daily routine is self-analysis. So that is what is a divine life. So in this, we should understand the particular thing of law of karma. Whatever a man sows, he will reap. Whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. So every day, this law of cause and effect system, the unfailing cause and effect system prevailing in the law of nature. Let me repeat, the unfailing cause and effect system prevailing in the law of nature. Otherwise, in a simple way, let us try to understand, nothing happens in the universe without a cause. Further, I will say, it's very simple. Everything happens in this universe perfectly. So let us accept this cause and effect system or the law of karma. Then you can proceed further, live and lead a blissful life. Accept every accident or incident it happens in your life by the divine judgment. Live simply, think nobly, feel divinity and act ideally. Be perfect in small things and little act day by day. Try to make each single day full of truth, selflessness, nobility and purity. What we strive out, sure to get it. So let us strive out and get what we deserve. And by the help of Guru, we will definitely realize the self, God realization, sure to get it. So then we must know the purpose of life. If you know the karma theory, then we must know what is next. It is the purpose of life. Man is born for the living of divine life here and the attachment of sublime, higher and spiritual experience. You are indeed divine. You are not merely a body or intellect. We are indeed divine. So let us now try to understand the purpose of life. Wake up now. Recognize your true identity and enter into the life of joy, peace, and wisdom, which is our essential nature. To attain your essential nature is the central purpose of your life. So the goal of life is God realization. Never forget this. It is our birthright. So now, the keys to happiness and success. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful. So for that, he just gives, and Albert Schweitzer gives an idea. Develop a clear-cut aim. Develop a clear-cut aim. Got your health. See how Swamiji has followed the same thing. Conserve your energy. Kayakalpa yoga. Got your health. Physical exercise. Develop a clear-cut aim. Value character. Adapt virtues. Meditate and introspect. Be kind. Serve others. If we follow this, simply the sky system. And happiness is our key to success. For that, one should have faith in God. Is it true? Is there God? But most of us have this idea. If so, why does he never show himself? When we have some pain and miseries, we will have all these questions will arise. Why has he left me down in so many times in my life? Whatever I want, I didn't get it. When I needed him the most, he is nowhere to be found. He is hiding. Or I lost him. That's how we think. Why there is no justice? If God is so good, kind and just, why does he let evil people to rule, come up in life? Why? Why do evil people succeed and good people suffer? Why? Because we don't have faith in God, all these things will appear. Okay. If something happens in our life, why we are blamed? Now for that, I will just ask you a few things. Are you sure you have never harmed or hurt anyone in your life by thought, word and deed? You made someone miserable. Think back, look back. Without facing problems, you want to go higher and higher in your life. Impossible. Selfish motive, dishonesty, name and fame, these all things will bring you down. Forgetting the kindness, loyalty, love, and your duty towards your family, a society, and the world community by and large. In life, misjudged and misled someone, is it not? Have you directly or indirectly made someone suffer for your selfish motive? In your workplace, in your own family life? Have you encouraged or being nice to an evil person? These are all things are the reason we are blamed. Then what are all the ancestral problems? We in our life, we did it. And what are all the ancestral problems? The difficulties that are created due to departed ancestors come in various forms just listed below. Inability to get married. If you don't get married, the girl you want, then you say, I'm not blessed. And you close your puja room. Marital disharmony. Addictions to many things. Going blank in your examination or in your interview despite of being well prepared for it. Why? Loss of job. It is all because of the ancestral problems. Difficulty in conceiving a child or miscarriages. Bearing a mentally challenged children or mentally retarded children or autism children with special needs. Death during childhood. These are all our ancestral problems. Why I'm telling you all these things? If you understand these are all things, then we will understand the life before birth and death better. Now I just made a basic foundation for you to understand. Now we will see the life before birth. We are from the mother's womb. Before mother's womb in the sex act, the X and Y chromosomes, XY and XX, a boy or a girl is born. And before that, there is a family tree. We are not just like that jumped into a mother's womb. It is all without a sperm and egg united together, you cannot bear a baby. So then when you go back like this, we are all from the divine. We're all from the divinity. Okay. With this, we will have many doubts. Many stories have been told by our elders. No, for that, let us try to understand the life before birth. For that, I would like to ask you a question. Man is a combination of body, soul, mind, and consciousness. We know body. Okay, let's go from this. Consciousness is a primordial state. Okay, mind is a result of body and soul. With jnanendriyas, using the biomagnetism, we form our mind, good or bad. Soul is very important, is a fractional consciousness. Now the body is an instrument or a vehicle for the soul to travel, to fulfill its unfulfilled desires or whatever we have brought while we are coming to this world, so that we need to enjoy by using this body, the vehicle. And body is a physical expression and vehicle to the soul. Now I would like to connect all these body, soul, mind and consciousness with a small example. See, let's see, man is a combination of body, mind, soul and consciousness. I just want to give this example. See, you're going to a discourse. You just bought a CD to hear afterwards. So you have just inserted the CD in your deck, but you are unable to hear. Why? Then if I ask you, then you will say, sir, I'm not given the volume, this, that. You may say many things. I'll say, connect it to the cable. Supply of the wire, supply is given to the deck. So when you given supply is given, you are not switched on. Once you switch it on, the electrons jumping through the wire and gets inside the deck, and the motor starts running at say about 7,800 RPM, whatever is designed for. Then you get only a humming noise. You have inserted a CD, but you are unable to hear the voice. Why? So the body is a whole hardware here. The connecting cable or the deck or the CD, all are the hardware. It is considered to be the body. Okay. Now the soul is the electrical energy which enters through the cable, electron jumping, moving, and it is started, the motor starts running. You're still unable to hear the song. Then you just called your, hey, I'm not able to hear. What is this? No, your daughter or a son, a grown up. Daddy, you might have inserted a blank CD, daddy. Please open it up and check. Surprisingly, you have inserted a blank CD. Oh my God, I made a mistake. So you took the right CD and then you inserted it. Then you are able to hear the voice. So the recorded portion, if the blank CD is only in hardware again, in the body, once it is recorded, is unseen in the CD. So mind is an unseen. You are unable to touch and feel. You can only experience it. So when the recorded CD is inserted, you are able to hear. Now we have understood in this concept, body, soul and mind. Now that is the fourth one, is their consciousness. Where in this system consciousness is coming into play? If somebody can just say, because wanting of time, I'm not using the chat box. Otherwise, I would have asked somebody to, what is the fourth one? The consciousness, where it is coming into play. Okay, let's move on. Where the consciousness coming into play? Okay, if you're not got the answer, I'll tell you. It is the order of function. It is the order of function. You may doubt, what is that order of function? If the deck is designed for 7,800 RPM, the motor has to run, then only you are able to hear the voice with that same modulation. Okay. So the order of function is as designed, 230 volts, and with that RPM, if it comes, suppose there is an electrical surge because of this rain, high voltage gets into your deck. Instead of 230, it goes up to, say, 300. Then what will happen? It is not as designed. It is not order of function. So it is now, you will hear the sound of the Chip and Dale. Quickie, quickie, you will hear. Or after some time, the electrical surge, it's just low voltage. then it will drag. So the consciousness is the order of function. So let us try to understand, man is a combination of body, soul, mind and consciousness. Body is the total vehicle. Without soul, it cannot function. And without mind, again, there is no use. And consciousness is the order of function. Okay, with this, we will proceed further with this understanding, the life before birth. Life before birth is the continuation of chain of birth. A child takes the form or blueprint carried over the balance, the imprint of karma. How it happens? The X and XX and XY, it gets XY, becomes a boy. So it just moves on. So that goes to from a single parent, and when as we trace, we are all from the God. The origin is from one source. So by the time, you know, you may have a doubt. Sir, many stories have been told. Can the disembodied soul can enter in the womb of a mother? The disembodied soul will never enter in a lifeless body or fetus. Let's move on. So then what are the stories told by our ancestors? Rebirth, reincarnation, soul attachment, or the words are different, all are the same phenomenon. The soul entered, they said, 5th month or 6th month or 7th month. Sorry, the soul starts a journey when the sperm and egg unites, it starts. Cell multiplication takes place, the soul is already there. Vary the question of 5th and 7th month, the soul is getting, entering into the body, the womb of a mother, impossible. Then people, they said, a grandfather, grandmother, great-grandmother, the dead will born again or enter again or reincarnation, soul attached, impossible. So if that is the case, if dead are born, then the population should remain constant. But it is not so. It is go on multiplying. Then when somebody asked this question, then some intelligent persons, you know, they said, no, we all came from monkey. When you look at it, the DNA structure, and today is the medical world, the DNA structure of a monkey and a human being is different. We have a 23 pairs of chromosome or 46. And you see, a human has got 46 chromosomes. A monkey has 42, a dog has 72, a cat has 38, mouse 40, and goes on. So it is impossible. You cannot go back. So the different DNA or different expression of a similar gene. So again, somebody will say, sir, there is a dolly sheep, you know, they made it. A dolly, dolly, they repeatedly. They have done it, but that has not survived it. So dolly was a cloning. That process is called cloning. In the Rosaline Institute, they had done it. It was born in July 15, 1996. See, please understand, even fifth sense animal to make a rip, the same image of dolly to make, you know, how many attempts they made? They made around 277 attempts. Imagine, for a fifth sense animal, a sixth sense man, every now and then our thinking changes. Impossible to clone a man. So the life before birth, we all came from our parents and parents only. That you don't have any other doubt. Now we will go to the life after death. Okay, we have seen life before birth and what one should do in your lifespan while living, what one must do. Focus your attention on the goal of life, God realization. For that, the tools and technique given by Sky and Swamiji, use it. Then life after death. Okay, what is death? Man is afraid of death. Man does not want to die. He wants to live forever. If a chance given, everybody will live. That is a starting point of philosophy. This is the starting point of a philosophy inquires and investigates. It boldly proclaims, "Oh man, don't be afraid of death." It's very simple. Death is a separation of the soul from the physical body. Your shirt is dirty, or something happened to your shirt while you are traveling. What do? You just go back and change your shirt. So likewise, the soul changes the body. It's just like thing. It is something like ice becomes water, and water becomes steam, vapor, and invisible gas, according to the degree of vibration. So life is in the physical, astral, and mental planes. So the death could be of three types. Death by an ordinary nature, you all know, due to illness and of the old age. And a premature death. Premature death is murder, suicide, accident, even a heart attack, or anything for that matter. If the body, the vehicle is in an order or perfect, for some other reason, if the soul is going out of the body, then it is a premature death. And the third type of death is salvation, jivan mukti. Death after perfection, purification of the soul, or self-realization. Now, we will see this three types in detail. Death of... Then soul's a journey after death. What happens once if the soul leaves the body? The soul contracts and withdraws all senses. The body becomes chill. Like, you know, the flame in a lamp becomes dimmer and dimmer. And then the oil is exhausted. And the flame goes off. So the same way, it leaves the physical body like a mist. After death, all these panchabhutas, five elements, are dissolved to reach their primordial state in the inexhaustible storehouse of the nature. The element of earth goes to join to its prithivi tattva. Likewise, all the panchabhutas goes back to its sources. There is no pain in the time of death. Let us try to understand. Ignorant people have created much horror and terror regarding death. What Swamiji says in Kayakalpa Yoga, life and death is because of the excretion of vital fluid from the body. In a sex act, one goes to a trance stage. A life starts. A little amount of fluid goes out of the body. We go to a trance state and the life starts. The whole vital fluid goes out of the body. Death takes place. So as little amount of fluid goes, we go to the trance state. And when the entire vital fluid goes out of the body, it is an unbelievable experience, a blissful state. So don't worry about the death. Okay. Life after death. The ordinary death of an ordinary nature. See, we say it is an old age. Old age is not truly the cause of death in and of itself. To die old age means that someone has died naturally for an ailment associated with aging. So maybe a failure of pancreas, failure of organs, or some kind of a dementia, or some kind of a tumor and things like that. The same uses, the same usually goes for dying of the natural cause. Suppose if someone dies at the age of 75, 80, lived happily and peacefully, so that is a natural death. Say in natural death, life force goes out of the body. When the body is no longer useful for the function of the soul. The soul to fulfill its desire, if it is not useful, it leaves the body. That's all. If the vehicle is broken, it is not able to use, although we are throwing out for a scrap yard, it's like that. And the soul cannot merge because it has got further imprints left. It's covering the soul. So getting attached to a like character for the dissipation of its imprint and desire is possible. Blood relation, husband, wife, children, is very suited for the soul because it has come from the same race, same mold. Its compatibility is more. A child dies, it gets attached to a mother with the compatibility, blood relation. Or the soul distribution takes place to the kith and kin. That is what the seventh day function or the 11th day function, kith and kins. We invite them. The first day, it is a soul distribution. And the seventh day or 11th day, whatever we do, call our kith and kins. That is a retail distribution, retail sale. So the retail distribution, friends and relations, prayer. Very low intensity desire due to old age and sicknesses. Okay. Then the rituals before burial and burning, what we do? Pouring milk and putting rice into their mouth. It is all to check the life force is there or not. Giving a bath. Why all they followed it? Those days, the medical science was not developed. So while giving birth, they tried to remove the clothes. They found out the vital fluid is totally drained. They find the vital fluid, then they will say, you cannot revive the life. So all these things, tying the toes and heads, it has all become rigid. Then it is very difficult. Once the soul goes out of the body, it becomes rigid. So for that reason, they keep all these things, the rituals, whatever they do it. Crying loudly or making some sound or firing crackers is to find out if a man in a coma state, he will get up. Otherwise, in those days, when they carry a man in coma state to the graveyard, then if he gets up, then the village, they will say he is a ghost. They will not take him into the village back. So for that reason, they just fired firecrackers, and even today it is all many places. They loud firecrackers or a huge sound, the huge decibel it has been. So if he is there in a state of coma, he will get up. And I've seen in many places if they come back, if they want to come back, they will spray many, they will throw many things, the food, eatables, and things like that. So that man gets up, he will come back. Or if they don't want to come back, if it is the soul which gives them trouble, I've seen in my life, many people throw nails very closer, maybe around 100 to 300 feet. They throw small nails. I don't know. This is the reason they don't want him to come back. And you can see even those days, a coffin is attached to a bell outside the coffin. You see the picture. They will have a hole and then a rope tied down to the hand. And in case if that man gets consciousness, then he will move the hand, the bell will ring, they will remove the body from the coffin. So those days it was. And all the rituals done because they were unable to find out he is in a state of coma or he is dead. So these are all the rituals being followed. So that is the life, natural death. And is a premature death, hanging, a murder, or this, any kind of death which the body is intact. Other organs are intact, any murder or even in a court, in a judgment, hanging till death. These are all premature death. The premature death, the soul wants to live. But it has been forced to, for various reasons, it is ejected out or thrown out of the body. So to cool to quench its thirst. No, it goes to a greenery closer to the area. It goes and joins in a tree, a green tree. Or it goes into a lake or a pond. It just gets inside. So that is why our ancestors, they say, don't sleep under a tree during night time and in an unknown place. And don't go and swim in an unknown place, a lake or a pond, where that soul may live. It may drag you inside. If you have a karma, you have it. You had it. And you can see the life after death. These are all the dictators. Look at all these dictators we have seen in our past, present, and then the man is living, Kim Jong-un, the North Korean dictator, and Idi Amin. I has killed about 3 lakh people. You all know about it. No, he used to eat human brain, human meat. Such kind of a dictators are also there. This kind of a dictators will give pain and miseries to the living people in the world. So the third kind of self-realization, samadhi, it's actually a liberation. Achieved satisfaction with the worldly things, and then beyond, everything is enjoyed. And somebody, you know, used to say, I'm waiting for God to take me out, to take me free from all attachments, imprint of sins dissolved through a good action, gets merges without delay. So this is self-realization and this is samadhi. We will discuss about it a little later. Okay. So life after death, the soul of the first and second will reach their end by getting attached, is what Swamiji says. The normal death and the accidental or death, the first and second, and the soul departs the body, the disembodied souls, will reach their end by getting attached and purifying their imprints. That is the only way out. With living men and women of similar character. So society has to bear the consequences while living and even after death. Hence, individual morality and their responsibility, the society insisted by our elders. So if we start living in a moral way of life and we understand the responsibility, the society is free from all these things. Otherwise, if you have all these, the greed, you will have these kind of dictators. So the interval between the death and birth, there are two factors decide this issue. The nature of the individual karma, or the last impression before death, whatever he carried. The interval is very long. It is because if you see the nature, if you are born on earth for 365 days a year, for earth 365 days a year, when you go to another celestial plane or you go to even Saturn, it is 30 years to go around the sun. See, like that, in celestial plane, the time is different. So that is why the interval between death and birth takes a longer period of time. By the time we forget all the experiences gained in this earth. And sometimes if that soul, you know, by suddenly by a shooting incident or by butchering or something like that, strong craving to live and the sensual attachment or even the vengeance to kill him back, all these things, they get reborn quickly or reattaches quickly. That is why in such cases, they are able to tell, this is my friend, this is my home. Reincarnation research. They all done it. You can see even in our own country, in our own villages, many things they will say, oh, they are my parents, they will say. Short attachments. the jiva resumes the thread very soon. There are some instances where a murdered person being reborn has declared the manner his death and revealed the identity of the killer also. Now look at these great souls, the Mahans, spiritually advanced persons, wait for a longer time before reincarnation or getting attached. Look at it, Vedatri Maharishi, Vallalar, it took about almost close to 100 years, 85 to 86 years. So what do we understand by this? Waste not this rare human birth. Remember that you came alone in this world, but also you will pass away alone in this world. We have come alone, we are going to go alone. None will help you accept what you have done in this life. Your deeds will search you out and follow you, as calves follow their mothers in the midst of their big herd. Therefore, waste not the precious time, but utilize every moment for the noblest cause. Finish your journey quickly by practicing the right sadhana, the spiritual endeavor, with the guidance of a guru. Swamiji very beautifully given the system, Vedatriyam. So then look at this Viveka Chutamani. Three things are very important, or it's very difficult to obtain. Being born as a human being, number one. And you are doubly blessed. You know where and when? Having a human birth is the first boon, the first gift, we got it. And an aspiration for liberation from the birth and death cycle. Thinking of that, practicing it, is indeed doubly blessed. And finally, triply blessed, a right guru showing the right direction in the shortest form to realization of self. So we are triply blessed. Those who are joined, those who are practicing, we are all triply blessed. The unique blessing has to be remembered always. Then alone, you will be careful not wasting the opportunity. See, this is what our great avayar, she says. She also says, getting birth as a human being is difficult. Jnanamum kalviyum, getting is again the second great thing. Following it and getting a good guru, doing charity and meditation, you will realize self. Even in own Sitar, Nandavanathil or Andi, he also says that Nalaru Madamai Kuyavanai Vendi, 4 + 6 begging, getting finally this human body without realizing the purpose for we got it, drinking and dancing, we leave the body. So all these things, and Bhagavad Gita also, Lord Krishna says, once obtained a human life with great difficulty and after a lot of strenuous effort, hence this body is most valuable. So I am giving you all these things, better prepared for it. Now I am going to give you some of these, whatever we have been taught, whatever we have been carrying for many generations. I'm just going to give my experiences. See, the Surendra Kumar Jain, a Jyotish Acharya from Bangalore, once we had been there, he comes in, in TVs, the TV programs in the early morning. See, once we had been there, and then you just go to his place, and then you take he will give you a plain paper, fold it, you write 3 of your questions and fold it and keep it into your packet. When your time goes, go get inside his room. Then you take the paper, piece of paper, the folded piece of paper, you wrote 3 questions. Keep it on some kind of a table he has given. He will not open it and see. He will simply say, this is what it is. Question number 1, question number 2, question number 3. He will quickly say. Then you will be surprised how he could read. Then of course we have myself, my wife, we had been there when we talked to him. Then he said, no, 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 I was surprised to see people coming with this type of three questions. Then he was talking to us for about half an hour. He asked all others to go out. Then he said, if we get an opportunity, I will also serve. People with a rare thinking, they come and ask me. Then I asked him, how you do all these things? Very simple. These are all possessing a disembodied soul with various techniques that reads your mind and it tells you, that's all. All these things, they are the capacity, they have another disembodied soul. It just reads my mind, whatever I have. They tell all the three questions of mind by read by the day soul, which he has with his experience or various techniques. You can use the soul to read others' mind. Once you go out, your mind or thinking changes. Whatever he said was true at that particular point of time. As soon as you go out, if your thinking changes, your direction changes. The same thing in Nadi Jyotisham also. Nadi in Tamil, it means in search of. Future, the past karma and the current action. The past actions are with us. The soul, it carries and can be read wherever by using a soul it can read. And what they say, the future predictions cannot be or can never be 100% accurate because you have changed your mind. 100 and odd thoughts you can, desires you can generate. So that is the reason you are unable to, even the Nadi Jyotisham, they are unable to predict 100% accurate. No, we have experienced it. You know, by sitting in your house, you ask some of your friend, go to the main road, ask his thumb impression. You don't know the person's thumb impression. Your friend also, no idea about that person. You take the thumb impression, go and give it to the Nadi Jyotidam, and they cannot just give you any prediction because you don't have any knowledge about that person. So that is the reason they are unable to tell. If your sister, brother, or your blood relation, you just take a thumb impression, they will tell because you know the data, biodata of your friends and relatives, or the thumb impression, he is able to read, the soul able to read and give you the details. Okay, these are all certain things I would like to clarify. And look at this child prodigy, a Microsoft certified professional. Lavina Sri, from the girl from Tamil Nadu in India, a Microsoft certified engineer at the age of 6, age of 9. Why? It is all the soul getting attached. The parents have no knowledge. The soul getting attached. So the same way I can give you 101, say the Priyasri Somani, a mental calculator, born in 16th November 1998, award winner of the mental calculation, the youngest participant in the mental calculation, World Cup 2007, an amazing kid award. See, all these things, you know, their parents have no idea. With that, at the age of, you know, very small age, getting that knowledge, winning over, it is nothing but the soul getting attached. One more, a Rahul Vallal, a child prodigy, a singer, a beautiful singer. His mother, Emma, and his father, Ravi Shankar Vallal, both are techies. They don't know anything about the music. They don't have any music background. The child, at sixth standard student in a Cornell public school in Bangalore, his videos have received all over the world. Look at it. It is again, he has performed Carnatic music concerts in many parts of India and abroad. How it is possible? Soul getting attached. So I can give you many, many examples like this. Village in Karnataka. No, the number just comes to his mind, he says, his father earns merely a meager living. He is only a laborer, daily wages, labor. And he has no idea about maths. And his intelligent quotient for that boy, the child, is 140. Our village is blessed, he says. See, there, sweetest grape grows. The Bajar Ragi means the village of knowledge. When you go and find out, a Jnani lived in that village, he wants to produce, he helps all those youngsters in that village to become mathematicians, to become a well-educated doctors, engineers, and two Indian IPS officers from that village. A Jnani just started giving all that knowledge, sharing his knowledge. So in that village, a lot of people are very intelligent. I just love to give you this Laws of the Spirit World, written by a Korshed Bhavanagri. You just buy this book, even in our bookshops or anywhere you can get it, about 300 rupees. Very beautiful book. Whatever Swamiji said, it is in line with that. The two his sons, at the age of close to about 24, 25, they just goes out for a car racing, met with an accident. Both of them died in that spot. One dies, subsequently the other one also dies, but they are worried about their mother. Oh, we are not able, I was supposed to, their marriages are organized. I'm missing my mother. So they're trying to talk to somebody else. Finally, they could get the mother through the thought reading process or somebody. Then he just consoles or convinces her mother, asked her mother to do a auto writing. In that process, this book has come. A Canadian writer helped this book to come out. You read this book, whatever Swamiji's line, the book reflects the soul. And this, he says, the laws of the spirit world, how it is. Very beautifully written. Read this book. I'd like to give another very interesting thing. A Border Baba, a soldier who died 50 years ago, still protecting the country's border. Will you believe it? It is in our military, the ghost soldier in Indian Army. He guards the Indochina border. That is why he is called as Border Baba, Haribhajan Singh. See the soul of Haribhajan Singh that guards Indian border. Every 14th September of every year, after his death, served about 4 years in an army, and he retired about 39 years afterwards his death. After his death, Indian Army gave him from a soldier to a captain. How it is possible? Even in the Indian Army it happened. This was done. And every 14th September, his uniform had been taken to his village. When that uniforms goes to his village, then they will post many securities or many border security force in the border. So he was a patriotic soul. He was guarding Indochina border. Any movement in China border, he used to tell all those in the border security force of Indian. Then they get ready. All the Chinese movement were stopped by because of this patriotic soul. By understanding this, Chinese also, in a flag meeting, a chair is kept vacant. They all feel and think the Border Baba Haribhajan Singh is sitting there in both the places. See, these are all happened. You just go to Google and check Captain Haribhajan Singh. And there are many examples like this in TV9 program, Mysore. Some time back, Veena Gowri's case happened. They all went and seen. She says, this is not my house. After giving a birth to one or two children, she said, my house is in Srirangapatnam. It was a very beautiful story. We all continuously, it has come, we followed that. And in TV9, Igu Unte, a program, it just came. Then they found the same thing happened, met with an accident, the soul getting attached to her. She goes back to Srirangapatnam. She says, this is my house. She shows the photograph. This is my childhood photograph. This is the place where I played. All these things happened. The four-year-old boy playing tabla. His father knew nothing about tabla. In fact, none in their family was musical. A 9-year-old speaking Sanskrit fluently. Parent completely ignorant of Sanskrit. One thing, when I talking to Swamiji, he said, this kind of a child prodigy getting attached, it will remain there up to the 15 years till they're getting their maturity. Then the original soul wants to live its life. So the attached intelligence knowledge will disappear after the age of 15 or 16. If it continues, it will become like Saguntala Devi till the birth, till their death. So in that case, the soul attached and the soul which is existing, that go, they take the journey together and realize God. So if the attached soul may leave after the maturity of that original soul, or if it continues with a compatibility, both will realize. This also we have seen. In Maharishi's life, you all know, when at the age of 42, on a full moon day, after 82 years or 86 years, in his veranda, he used to sleep in his veranda, and Ramalinga Vallalar came and he said, I am going to live with you for the next 10 years. So Ramalinga Vallalar lived with Swamiji for 10 years, the soul getting attached. So Swamiji says, it is my impression that using my humble self as a medium, Ramalinga Swami completed the work left unfinished by him through me. On many occasions, he has been my guide, and I treasure the event in my memory. So this soul getting attached. Even Ramana Maharishi, at the age of 14, he experiences a death. Some Mahan's knowledge getting transferred to him, he started doing the Vichara Marka. Who am I? So life before birth and after death, three combined defects: ignorance of truth, ego, imprint of sins, karma, undue attachments, maya. These three combined defects to be purified or erased, purifying the soul, taking an inner travel by meditation, by a systematic psychic practice, you can avoid. How to avoid soul attachment? Reduce your frequency. No fear of death after understanding the life before birth and death. No mirror gazing practices during night time. Do Turiyadit meditation daily. Don't do your Turiyadit meditation at an unknown place and an unmanned places. Moralize your desires. I'm talking about how to avoid soul attachment. Reduce your frequency. Higher frequency, all those things, imprints are there. At a lower frequency, never the soul get attached, because you are not compatible for the greedy soul. So don't do your mirror gazing during night time. Do Turiyadit meditation daily, and do not read and see horror movies and read books. Avoid travel in an unknown place or an unmanned places. And how to get good souls attached? When you do Turiyadita meditation, when you are with the negative souls, or the evil souls or the trump souls or there the earthbound souls. It is called Salogyam. Salogyam, earthbound souls. It reflects when you are in emotional mood, you get attached to the earthbound soul, Salogyam. When you do a regular meditation, go to a Samibhyam in the solar field. Then you get attached to a higher level or elevated soul without any attachments, earthbound attachments. You will get attached to a higher level or intelligent souls. When you go to Samibhyam, near to God, with the functional universe, they're all the Mahans, Buddha, Christ, all these, you know, they're all there in the higher level, very closest to the functional universe, end of the functional universe, Sarubhyam. When you do your Turiyadit meditation, then what happens? You go to a delta wave, 1-3 frequency, very closer to the divinity. You get attached or you download all these higher souls, then your life changes. Swami, Saijyam is a static state. Beyond that, if you, some souls, you know, they don't want to come back to the world and to serve to the humanity, though they go back to static state, Saijyam. So this is how it works. Then you will have a doubt, can soul enjoy pain or pleasure? What Swamiji says, there are 8 things: physical body, astral body, biomagnetism, genetic center, brain cells, soul, sensing organs, and mind. If they all works together continuously in coordination, is called life or living. Out of this, even one goes out of the body, it is called death. So it cannot function. There is no pain or pleasure to the soul. See, you have a cut or something, you have a pain. You are just holding that hand and you are pain. You're putting a lot of things, all that, painkillers and things. When you go to sleep, will you experience the pain? No. So no pain or pleasure to the soul. Example is a dream. Or when you are in a deep sleep. So the summary is, may the humanity entirely develop to spiritual knowledge and enjoy the harmonious, blissful and peaceful life. Be blessed by the divine. Valga Valamudan. Be blessed by the divine. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. I thank you all and I bless you all for a good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity, wisdom and peace. Be blessed by the divine.
Be blessed by the divine. Thank you very much, sir, for the amazing speech on the topic life before birth and after death. You have clearly explained with a beautiful presentation and all the theories told by the yogis, including our great yogi, Guru Vedatri Maharishi. And also various practical and live examples you have quoted for the clarification of all the participants today. I hope all our participants today enjoyed the speech and understood the philosophy of life before birth and after death, as it was explained by our Guru. Thank you, sir, for the excellent speech. Now the forum is open for discussions. Please click the raise hand button in your Zoom app to ask your questions. While you get ready with the questions, we have some important announcements to make. Please practice Kayakalpa Yoga regularly to improve your immunity system. If not yet learned Kayakalpa Yoga, please visit kayakalpayoga.edu.in. Also recommend it to your friends and relatives to practice Kayakalpa, especially in this COVID situation. WCSC Vision for Wisdom is conducting online foundation and certificate courses in Tamil, English and Kannada. Please visit kundaliniyoga.edu.in to know in detail. Our monthly journal Anboli is also available in the Android app. Download the application from the Android Play Store and get access to the premium content of our Swamiji speeches. Connect with us on Facebook and YouTube on the channel Sky Yoga TV to listen to all the past speeches of our professors on various aspects of Sky Yoga. Karma Yoga principles of Vedatriyam suggest donating 1% of our income to the good causes of society. Be generous and donate to the World Community Service Center. You can do that either through the Anbuli app or through our official website vedatri.edu.in. Now let us move on to the discussion session. Rajaraman sir, please unmute yourself. We request the participants to state your questions directly. Rajaraman sir, please unmute sir.
Yes, Rajaram here from Chennai.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, sir. Sir, Professor sir, you have given me very, very educative and explained the soul position before birth, after death. Mm-hmm. It is very educative, very impressive, excellent and amazing. Now it is already 9. Yeah. Can you spare 5 more minutes to discuss?
Absolutely, sir. I am free.
Okay, okay, sir. No, I got a number of questions. Please answer, sir.
Yes, sir.
First of all, the soul attachment, how it happens?
Yeah.
The soul departed from a body attaches to another body either through 9 holes or any organs.
Yeah.
First.
Okay.
Then.
Let me answer that. It is something like an energy packet. The departed soul is just going to an energy form. In a magnetic field, this magnetic field compatibility is there, it merges.
Okay. Not through organs.
No, not through organs. Yeah.
Okay. And another question is, when the body is there before cremation, we tie the toes by a knot.
Yeah.
Why, sir? What for?
It is, you know, if it opens up, or if it is, you know, it is something like it is opens up, you're not, it is very good. Now, if it is widens or taking away, you know, if it just widens, it's very difficult to bring it back. The body becomes stiff. So that is why they tie down. See, the mouth is opened, it looks ugly. So all these things they tie down to avoid the stiffness. To avoid, and then to, while burying, it becomes very difficult. That is the reason. See, those days, in a caffeine and many things, you know, if it wide open, the caffeine is very small, you cannot put it in. And even the while burying also. Okay.
Next question is, almost all dead bodies are covered by white cloth. What is the reason, sir?
White cloth, you know, it looks to be clean and neat, that's all. And why they give the bath, I told you as it is, to check out the vital fluid is removed. The entire vital fluid is drained to check out that life can be revived or not. But white cloth, you know, whatever that was available, the new cloth that was available those days from a weaving community, they buy it, they just put it there. That's all and nothing else.
Okay. Next question. Yeah. When you go to the graveyard, when you burn the body, why fire is put on the chest?
Why the?
Fire.
Many times, you know, it is in a leg and head area. I don't have any right thinking or answer. I've seen many times they lit the fire but different places. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know, sir. I will find out and let you know. Sure.
Okay, sir. Last one.
Yeah.
Usually in villages, when the body is taken by a buyer to the graveyard, usually they use green leaf.
Yeah.
Coconut green leaf.
Yeah.
And tied in unproportional way, contrary to nature.
Yeah.
For what purpose they are using that coconut leaf mat?
That is very simple. That was the those period it was available. They just gave it accordingly. They just put it there. And take it was only that the material was available those days, they were using it. I don't think so. There is no other. If it is not available in many places, they were taking it with simply with a bamboo stick they used to carry.
That the thatch is knitted in opposite direction. I want to know, sir.
Though when you know, go near the graveyard, they turn it. Is it that's what you're asking?
No. The coconut green mat is not knitted in the proper way. It is opposite direction. Knitting is opposite direction.
Oh, I don't know. I will have to find out. Okay, sir. Oh, because maybe I will think, maybe if they throw it, they should not be taken back and used it for other uses. That may be the reason.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for good reply. Thank you. Be blessed.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for answering the questions in a clear manner. Next, Vatsala ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Valga Valamudan, sir. I'm Vatsala from Vidyaranyapura Center. It is a pleasure to talk to you after a long gap, sir. I've been trained under you and ma'am for a long 5 years. Sir, I have a couple of questions with you on the subject matter. Parents, you know, of a kid, are expired. And what are the chances of the souls getting attached to a child? That is one question. And if it gets attached to the child, a son or a daughter who is closer to them, how will they know that the soul is the soul of the parent is attached? And how do we act it? And how do we as a child, proactively fulfill their desires? Because of the unfulfilled desires, they have attached to our body. And how do we know that, this is our duty and we have to fulfill it?
Okay. See, if it is a small child, generally, it attaches with the mother. See, a small child, their desires are up to age of 14. It may not manifest. So that a mother cannot feel and understand. Okay. When is the elderly person with a compatibility, when the elderly person dies, its compatibility, it attaches to their son or daughter grown up. You can see the parents' behavior to the attached mother or son or a daughter.
Right.
You know, their behavior, you can see that emotionally they will talk, they will cry, biting the nail. And many of their, whatever they followed in their lifestyle, you can see it is reflecting in the soul attached men or women or the daughter or son. That you can find out. So that you can see, a 65-year-old, a great jamindar or somebody, was living, suddenly his 45-year-old son had a sudden heart attack, the panchayat, the great man dies. Then immediately the soul getting attached to the elder son. The elder son will behave like a patel, village patel, like his father. Then people will say, that boy, his son, 45-year-old son, was just walking behind like a silent fellow. After his father's demise, immediately his behavior is like his father. Movement, everything you can see. That is why those things you can see in their body movements, thinking, talking, everything.
How do you know that, these are the desires of our parents who are no more with us? Yeah. And how do you fulfill them, sir, as a child, how do you fulfill them?
Okay. The fulfilling, then you are controlled and guided when your soul is in a very dormant state. Your energy in a very low level, that will function and that will guide you or help you, or that will maybe on the other way also it will work. No, suddenly people, they will realize, I want to buy a house, I want to sell a house, I want to make some property. If the parents have that unfulfilled desire of buying some property in a place or selling their property, and they don't want to sell the property, it is very difficult. Even you want to sell the property, lot of litigations will come without any expectation. You are unable to sell the property, a land or whatever it is. It is all because of the influence of the soul attached. You can see it. Some properties, you want to sell it after the demise of your parents. Then suddenly a lot of properties, litigations will come. They don't want to sell the property. They want you to enjoy, but you want to sell. That is what the difficulty. Then you can understand the soul getting attached. These are all things, small things you can really understand. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Next, Priya Senthil ma'am, please unmute yourself.
One general question, sir.
Yeah.
If the couple is not having kid, I heard that karma is not followed for them. Is it true?
Of course. There is no, once you bear a child, you'll have to bring them up, educate them, getting married, do all those things, you know. That kind of karma is not there. But the karma, the present life imprint and the prarabdha karma, whatever you did, that will carry on with your soul. There you cannot escape. Understand? The present life imprint and the Sanchita karma of 7 generations, whatever your soul carries, that one, after you depart your body, then you'll have to fulfill the desire by getting attached. You don't think that I don't have a son or a daughter, I don't have a rebirth or soul getting. Don't think that way, okay?
No, sir, I'm not asking like that. If the couple is having one boy or a girl, the karma is followed to a single boy or girl. Yeah. Yes, it's a good or bad. Okay. If they are having two kids, the karma is followed to two kids.
See, if you have a boy and a daughter, a son and a daughter, carrying your son, your state of mind was in a liberated mood. I want to liberate myself. No, you are a God-fearing parent, both of you. After 10 years, you got a son. So that boy will never get carry your imprints, because the state of mind, whatever you are carrying while you conceived and carrying, a God-realized person, you wanted a jnani, you got a jnani. Your boy will never get it. But after some time, you have you conceive and carrying. So by that time, you see the world. You want to be buying this, that, your mind is changed. So all that desirous things will go to your daughter. Your son may be a saint, but daughter may be a greedy person. It is all depends on the state of mind when you conceived and carrying. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And finally, you have Mr. Bhaskara Pandian, sir. Please unmute yourself.
Be blessed by the divine Satyamurthi. I want to know this, Dr. Surendra Kumar Jain, which TV channel, which timing is coming?
No, he is in Fraser Town. If you want, I'll send you the address.
No, Fraser Town, I have gone to him nearly 30 years back. I think his father was there at the time. Now he may be the son.
Yes. Correct. You're right.
But the TV program, you don't remember the channel.
He comes in many Kannada TVs, the Jyotisha, today's Jyotisha, he tells.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Money.
He's a renowned person.
I have gone to that place. I think his father was there at that time. I heard afterwards children have taken over.
Correct. When I had an experience, I shared, this is what it is. He said, it is all the soul, because there are various techniques they observe, they just possess one soul. But that soul will help them to read our mind and tell.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
All good.
Thank you, sir. Be blessed by the divine. Thank you so much for patiently answering all our questions and sharing your insights and divine thoughts. It's always an interesting topic and a lot more questions will be there. Thank you for making us our time today, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Dear Sky Meditators, it's time for us to express our gratitude. Let's come to Durya state. Senior Professor T. Satyamurthy, sir, be blessed by the divine. His good health be blessed by the divine. His loving family, be blessed by the divine. His divine service, be blessed by the divine. Now let us bless our Professor Uma Srikant ma'am for conducting Shanti meditation. Professor Uma Srikant ma'am, be blessed by the divine. Her good health, be blessed by the divine. Her loving family, be blessed by the divine. Her divine service, be blessed by the divine. We are happy to bring the following online programs live from Alaya Temple of Consciousness tomorrow. Morning 5:25 a.m. 9 Central Meditation in Tamil, 6 a.m. Exercises in Tamil, 7 a.m. 9 Central Meditation in English, and by 11 a.m. there is a speech in Tamil on the topic Kudumba Amaidi by Professor Purushottaman from Australia. Evening 6 p.m. 9 Central Meditation in Tamil, 6:30 p.m. there is a retelecast of morning's Tamil speech, and 7:30 p.m. Divine State Meditation in Hindi by Professor S. Dhanalakshmi from Chennai. And by 8 p.m., we have speech in Hindi on the topic Karma Yoga by Professor Sokesan from Chennai. Please share this program invite with your friends and relatives. Let everyone take part in the spiritual journey and get benefited. We thank our beloved President Arulnidhi Padmashri SKM Mayalanandan sir for his support and guidance. See you all tomorrow again with another interesting session. Till then, be safe, practice our Kundalini Yoga. This is Ramesh from the Aliyar World Community Service Center IT team. Let us conclude the program with the invocation for the world peace. May the world be blessed with plenty of rain. The farmers work to produce an abundance of grain. Let the practitioners of all trades prosper, flourish and grow. And culture progress through the need to share and grow. Let the rules be beyond feelings of anger or fear, illiteracy, poverty, and all evils made to disappear. Let the true lamp of knowledge burn steady and bright. Our sense of duty guide us along path always right. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Have a good night.